Hi everyone, Steve the Builder here. Glad to have you in my workshop again, and we've got lots to do again today, so it's going to be lots of fun. So let's start on the model that I was sanding. You can see all the mud guards are on, that's cool, and I'm just giving a little bit of a sand on these sharp little edges, like so, just to make sure it doesn't cut anybody if they catch their finger on a sharp corner. So I've done most of that, just finishing off that little last bit there. Stops any sharp edge being a danger to you.
I see you've sanded off all the filler too, Steve.
Yeah, that's all nice and smooth, so we're going to paint that in a second. So let's get the paint out and try the paint and see what it goes like. Off comes the lid. Quick stir. And we'll start putting some paint onto this model and let's make it look a lot better. So you can't even see where those screws went in the top there the other day. And then when we've finished this undercoat, we could put a top coat on, see what colours we've got. I'm not quite sure what we've got there. Ideally, it'd be nice to have some red because Harvey's granddad's tractor had a red bonnet by the look of it on the photo. It's going to look a lot better when it's painted, don't you think, Linda?
Absolutely. I think all our lovely children will love it.
Love to play with this one.
I know,
finished.
Otis will love it.
Oh, good old Otis. Wonder how he's getting on. He's such a good model maker. He loves his model making.
He does.
Actually, talking of model making for Otis and others, if you've got some stuff in your box, like I've got a big box here of my recycle things, you don't have to make a car or a bus or any of those things. You can make something totally different. You might want to make, say, well, look, you could make a rocket. I know Kai loves rockets, and we were going to make a rocket, weren't we, Kai, before our lockdown? But look, that could be a rocket, or you could make that into an aeroplane with a tail on it, maybe like so, and some wings, make an aircraft. I know there's been some good boats made, and we could make a house or a castle like last time. In fact, that's just reminded me, Linda, I found in our cupboard a box with a castle on it, and it's a castle from Frozen. Look at this. Remember.
Goodness, won't our children love that?
Won't they love playing with that? I'll open that up in a couple of days and we'll get the blocks out because I'm going to talk about making things with blocks. So that'll be fun.
We could even make a beautiful frozen land, couldn't we?
That'd be right, lots of fun.
Yay.
So we'll get that open when we can. Once I've finished painting, maybe. So that's going to be exciting. You could make one out of the boxes, a castle, couldn't you?
Mm-hmm.
With turrets and a moat and a big drawbridge and so forth. Lots of things. So you don't have to limit yourself to cars like I've been doing lately. It could be any sort of model. So let me just carry on with this painting a wee bit. And then we'll look at the miniature models that we were working on last Friday. And get that done and out of the way. So what we're going to do is just cover this all up with undercoat. Then I'll need another little sand. And after that little sand, we can put a top coat of colour on it. As I say, we could use a red bonnet for like in that photo there, but I'm not sure if I've got red paint. This looks so much better with its mudguards on, Linda.
Mm-hmm. I think it would look better with its wheels on too.
I know, we're just going to put the wheels on last because they'll be painted different colour and they'll have their tyres on them, of course. Actually, I should whiz one on. I'll show you how I do it again with the Vivid just to get it started, because this makes it a great idea to get the round circle, nice and neat, by just holding the pen in one place and whizzing the wheel around. So watch this. We did this the other day. Now, actually, tractors have quite big tyres, so we're going to come in a bit closer. How's that look?
Cool.
So that'll help me paint that, because it'll just give me a line to go by so that I can go straight, because otherwise it's quite hard to get a nice round painting job done. So take that wheel off and put a bigger one on, and we'll get them all done like that. And then they will fit, once they're painted and the whole car, the whole tractor's painted, they can go on. It'll look great, won't it? Same with this one.
Going to look great.
So I'll carry on with that.
Playing with that.
They will carry on with that later on, because we just need to finish off a little model that we were making over here. Remember, we had the bulldozer done. Stop those back in my box. We had this bulldozer done. I had little bits of little strings of glue hanging off it, but I've picked those away, so that's quite nice. So that bulldozer is ready to go to your magic land and push the dirt around. That'd be good. Now we're going to do a front end loader, but look, I found this truck, and it's got a tip truck, and it's got 8 wheels. So I thought, I had a box roughly that big and lots of buttons, so I thought maybe we could glue some buttons on our box and make a version of that. What do you think of that?
Looks wonderful.
So we might try that, eh?
Mm-hmm.
Right, I'll get my glue gun. If you haven't got a glue gun, of course, you could use some sellotape.
Looks a little bit like a bus, too.
Does at the moment.
We're going to be talking about buses this week.
I'm copying the side like that.
Oh, so it's more of a tip truck, definitely.
It will be a tip truck when it's finished, I hope. Because we need one of those down the magic land, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
We're taking all the dirt around. So the front 2 wheels and the back 2 wheels go to, sort of together a bit more, don't they? So I'll just slide that one along a bit. Get a lot of the stringy stuff from the glue. This glue's stringy. You have to pull it off later, harder. Look. Lots of stringy glue on it. Let's try the other side. These are buttons out of your Nana's button box.
There's lots of buttons there, Steve. You'll have to count and make sure you've got the right number.
Yeah, I think I've got 8. One more black one. I thought I had 8 black ones, but I must need a green one. That's sort of like that one's not really black either. Dark blue, that sort of do the trick.
Shall we count and just check that they're
Shall we count
on?
Them? That's a good idea. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
So 4 on one side.
And 4 on the other side. So 4 and 4 make 8. 4 and 4 make 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Mm. That's an equation that big people do.
Right, what do we need? The next step is just maybe to cut the back out of here so it can take a load in it. I should have done the cutting before putting the wheels on, because they're pinging, pinging off as I cut it.
So even Steve the Builder has failures.
Yeah, lots of times. But you don't worry about your failures, you just carry on and try again.
That's right.
So what we'll do is we'll do the cutting, and then I'll, whoops, see, I'm going to fold the box. This is quite hard to cut. I don't want to cut my thumb either. I might use the scissors, it'd be a bit safer, don't you think, Linda, than the knife?
Very much safer.
So let's just use the scissors and I'll have to glue those wheels back on again. Right to the end. So some of the things I'd like to build in the future coming up, Linda, is a castle with the blocks. And I would also like to try going back. We've been talking about vintage cars. What say we go back to the Stone Age and look at Fred Flintstone's car? Has everybody heard of Fred Flintstone? You might not have. But Fred lived in the Stone Age. So his car was made of stone. It's not really true. It's just pretend. But if you haven't seen Fred Flintstone, ask Mum or Dad. They might show you some on YouTube. I might see if I can find a clip to show you. Right, now we're going to just cut this off over here. Cut that bit down like so. Still a bit short. It's going to be the cab up there, cab end, isn't it? This end will have the headlights on the front, but like that truck there on the front, and then it'll have the back. You can put stuff in here. It needs a tailgate on the back to open, doesn't it, Linda? So now we can put the wheels back on. There we are. The wheels are back on, and the cabs in the front, and the bit there for carrying the dirt and so forth. So all we need is some windows on the front, and some headlights drawn on. And it'll be ready for the road and ready for the digger to put the dirt in. So let's have a look where the windows are in this truck here. So it's one about here. And there's one in the front. Let's have a look at the front. There's two in the front. They go like so. Windows so the driver can see out. Another one on this side. And some headlights. He's got a grill. Remember the grill on my ute lets the air go through to keep the motor cool. A wee bit like a face, isn't it? There we are. So that truck's ready to go to Magic Land and do some carrying of dirt with the bulldozer we made the other day. Not only we've got my bulldozer we made, but we've got one here. So there's going to be lots of action at Magic Land with the trucks ready to go and the bulldozer's ready to go. This big bulldozer. Maybe the truck could take the bulldozer there. Big load. So tomorrow, boys and girls, we'll put the tractor together and it'll be all painted. And I'm going to finish off this video today with a little picture of Fred Flintstone's car. So you can wonder how we might be able to make that one. So until then, we'll see you. Make sure you look after your parents. Bye-bye for now.